Hello guys, today I'm going to show you guys how to draw an anime girl in kimono. So most of you guys probably already know that kimono is basically traditional Japanese dress, but there are many types of them. And the one that most people probably think about is yukata, which is basically a summer casual kimono, I mean full body dress with a butterfly on the back. So let's get started. First off, I'm going to zoom in a little bit, and also you can see that this girl, she's waving her arm so that you can see the sleeve. But we're going to start off with the color, which is going to be here. And then, of course, I'm going to erase a part of this so that you can still see the ghost. I hope you guys can see the lines that I've drawn. And also, the hairs, those two strands is going to be covering. I mean, those are going to be in front of the dress, obviously. Okay, so for those who have already seen a lot of anime, this dress is something that is very recognizable. And it's basically a very large collar and also very hard one. So remember, this one is really hard. It's a very thick fabric. So most likely there isn't any creases or folds there. Actually, the same goes for the rest of the dress. So remember, when you draw this yukata, remember that there should be minimal creases, and if there are creases, try to make those creases large. And here I'm gonna draw the band that's gonna be binding the dress together. And this band is going to be very large, and it's also going to be very thick, and it's going to be right below the breasts. So the breast is right above it, like that. Maybe it's a little bit too thick, I think. No, this is okay. Like this, a little bit shorter, like this. And then this separation here continues down below this band, but below the band there is something like this. So it looks like it's kind of a top or a shirt, but this is actually a part of the dress, so it's a whole body dress. And then of course these legs are gonna be erased. But let us just go ahead and draw the sleeve first. And this is something very, very symbolizing, I guess. Because the sleeve is a very large sleeve behind this thing. And a part of it goes like this, I think. Okay, so the sleeve is this long. This is exact. Oh, I'm sorry. What of the camera there? But you know, the sleeve. I'm gonna erase this the leg. Okay, so the sleeve is gonna be this large, going down like here. But the thing about this sleeve is that it's actually like a pocket something. I mean, it's not like a pocket, but there's a kind of a hole there, and then it kind of goes together like this. But of course it's not sewed together, it's still separated there, but that's just how it is. And also it's gonna be very like this. And actually, I think this one is a little bit strange because her arm is pointing a little bit towards left, so I'm gonna move this a little bit to the right, so it looks like her clothing is being pushed back like that, and then it falls down like this. Pretty good. And then I'm gonna finish the dress, I mean the lower part of it, which is just going to be a dress down there covering the whole two both legs. And of course I'm going to erase both of these, and then you just follow the line down there, maybe a crease there. Like this. Pretty good. Pretty good. But actually, I think I'm gonna erase that part and then add a crease on this side instead. We're just gonna be like this. I'm gonna make this clearer soon, but let's just finish the rest of the dress. But I'm just gonna include this separation with gold, which goes all the way down to the bottom of it, which is gonna be like this. Also, make sure that you can see that this thing is, on top of the lower part of the dress, like that. And then, of course, you can't see the other side because it's being covered by the sleeves, like that. And then there's gonna be a lot of creases here because the sleeve kind of folds onto itself like that, but it's very many lines there now. Okay, I think this one is too strange. I'm actually just gonna make this pretty straight down because it's gonna fold onto itself. It's not gonna get stiff. And then the rest of this one, actually I'm gonna make something like, I don't know, some creases there like that. It's gonna cover a part of the hand is gonna be pushing a part of it up like that. And also this part is gonna have a large crease like this. Like that. And then on this side, which is gonna be much easier because there's so little folding. It's just gonna be like this. Make sure you get the height of it identical. And then it's gonna be like a line there because it creases like this. And maybe some lines there, but I don't think so. I'm just gonna erase that, and it's pretty good. Now I'm just gonna make this clearer, and also, as I've said, it's thick, so make sure that you get this part, which is the end of the sleeve, showing that it's very thick, like this. And then I'm just gonna give her some folds there. And then don't forget that there is a rope like thing in the middle of this band, which is gonna have a butterfly knot in the middle of it, something like this. It's not really that important, giving it thickness, because most of the time this rope is quite thick. And then, of course, the butterfly behind her, which is gonna be like this. Oh, I'm sorry. Went off the camera again. But I didn't really do much. It's just that I redraw some of the lines in order to make this part clearer, because, you know. And I still think that this one is a little bit strange, but maybe it's just my opinion. Now I'm just gonna erase the whole thing and go ahead and make this a little bit more natural, like it goes more straight down like that. And then there's the line, and this one is a little bit too thick. I've drawn too many lines. Okay, again, try to make lines thinner, straight down like that. Make the same height, which is gonna be around there, and then and it does not have that much folds like that. And then her hip is this wide, so it has to, I mean, there has to be a line there simply because of the dress. And we're pretty much done. Actually, there's something left. It's the feet. So I think that yukata most often used with a shoe that is gonna be, I don't know what they're called, sandals, yeah, traditional Japanese sandals, which is a wood plate below the feet and then some straw bands or whatever on top of it, like this. Like this on this the other side down there, and then the wooden plate, which is gonna be like this. That's pretty good. So now the only problem I have is that this is a little bit too short, because the Japanese people tend to try to cover, I mean, Japanese women traditionally tend to try to cover their legs. They don't tend to show it too much. Like this. And of course we have to redraw the hair, as I've said, and I'm gonna erase a part of the color so that I can include it to the side down here, and this one is gonna just go to that side, and then behind is just gonna go down to here, waist length. That's probably good. Just a small bump there, not a bump, just something sticking out. So if you just zoom out again, oh, I'm sorry, just mess with the camera. You can see that this is pretty good. Can't really complain. It's just that this one, I think if I do it like that, it will look much more beautiful. And then actually if I just erase this line, so it looks like the sleeve is like this, and then the rest of the dress is behind it. That's gonna look much better, I think. Yes, that's much better. Okay, so I think we're done. But of course, before we finish the video, I'm just gonna do some shading, of course, to the hair of this girl. Now a lot of people is gonna say that, why do you always draw girls with dark hair? Well, last video I drew a girl with a light hair, so I think I can do this. with, I mean, this video can be with a girl with black hair. Then also the whole band, which is most often black or yellow, or not yellow, blue or pink or red or purple. And then, why is this so light? Okay, and then I'm just gonna do some shadowing below the cheek and inside of the ear, and then on this side of the slit collar, and also inside of the sleeve, inside of this sleeve, and then below this crease there, this large one, and then also on the legs, I mean on the feet. And also on the dress behind the sleeve, like that. And of course, when you have shadows beside it, you have to make the lines a little bit clearer so as people can see where you're drawing. And I'm just trying to make some creases more a little bit clearer, like that. And then I'm just gonna give her some shadows inside of the hand and on the, I mean, on this butterfly knot, which is on the back, like that. Also making this a little bit. Actually, I'm gonna switch pencil in order to make things a little bit clearer. Why didn't I switch pencil much earlier? I honestly don't know. Okay, so I know I'm just wasting time now doing this retracing thing, but it is a part of drawing. So most often you want to, I mean, weaken all your lines in order to redraw all the lines. What do I make a made a mistake there? But now we're lazy and therefore we're skipping that erasing part, and now we're just redrawing all the lines directly. That was a mistake. Should be more like this. That's pretty good, I think. And I think we're done. So if we just zoom out again. Okay, some more lines. I'm sorry, guys. Just some more. Forgive me. We're pretty close to being finished. It's just that it annoys me to keep those lines. And then some lines on the feet too. I know you guys don't even pay attention to this, but it's still a part of it. And it's really important to keep them clear. I know I have a tendency to not finish the video smoothly, but now we're finally finished. Okay, so thank you guys for watching, and let me just zoom out a little bit and place the whole drawing in the middle of the video, and it's time to say goodbye. I hope you guys learned something new. Okay, I'm just gonna take away some of this debris. Okay, I hope you guys learned something new, and if you have any questions or requests, just leave that in the comment section below, and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I will be back with another video pretty soon. So, see you guys next time. Goodbye.